हेलो एवरीवन, माई सेल्फ संजय उटगे, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स इंजीनियरिंग, वालचंद इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी, सोलापुर। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस इंट्रोडक्शन टू मैटलैब पार्ट 5, लर्निंग आउटकम। एट द एंड ऑफ दिस सेशन स्टूडेंट्स विल बी एबल टू डेमोन्स्ट्रेट system behavior using different analysis tools and functions available in MATLAB. Example, n equals to 5, s is equals to 0, for I is equals to 1 colon n, s is equal to s plus I, and display s. So in this example, I have declared a constant which is having value n is equals to 5, another variable s is equals to 0. I will change the value of I, which is a third variable, from 1 to n, that is 1 to 5. So I will take a value as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So this will come into the loop for I is equal to 1 colon n. It will execute, each time it will execute the expression s is equal to s plus I, which is having a value initially 1. So s it will be, s value of s will be 0 plus 1, it is 1. Next, it will take a value I equals to 2. So s will be equals to 1 plus 2, it will be 3, and so on. So this for loop will continue till I is equals to 5, which that is value of n. And finally, it will display the result, that is display S, which is 15. Another example, let us again define n is equals to 5, s is equals to 0. Then in a loop for I, which I 1 to n, then execute expression s is equal to s plus I square, end. So again here also n having value 5, s initially 0, I that will take a value from 1 to n, that is it will change after execution of a single loop, it will change to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. The loop will stop when I will reach to 5. So each time the expression is executed as s is equal to s plus I square. So once I becomes equals to 5, it will come out of the loop, and finally it will display the last value of s, and which is 56. Now let us take another example. N equals to 5, for I is equals to 1 colon n, display square root of I, and remember here we are using two brackets, one bracket for displaying a quantity, that is square root of what, a square root of I, and so initially it will display the square root of I is equals to 1, it is 1. Next it will display the square root of 2, which is 1.4142. next time it will display a square root of 3, which is 1.7321. again the fourth loop, it will display a square root of 4, which is 2, and finally I is equals to n, that is 5, it will display the square root of 5, which is 2.2361. Another example, sum is equals to 0, for I is equals to 0 to 100, with a difference of 5, sum is equal to sum plus I, and display sum. Now in this example I have assigned value to sum is equals to 0 initially, then in a for loop I will take values from 0 to 100 with a difference of 5. That means it will take all the values between 0 to 100 with a difference of 5, that is 0 5 10 15 20 25 30, and so on till 95 and 100. And after taking a value of I, this difference value, it each time it will execute the expression sum is equal to sum plus I. So the execution will come out of this for loop once I reaches to a value 100. Once I reaches to a value 100, it will execute the expression sum is equal to sum plus I, and it will display a sum, and which is the answer 1050. Nested loop. In nested loop, you will find multiple loops. The first loop is for n is equal to 1 to 5, means it will take value of n from 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So within this loop, there is one more loop which will take values of m from 5 to 1 with a difference of minus 1. So m will change from 1, 4, 3 to 1, whereas n will change from 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And it will execute the equation A n comma n. It's a matrix A with n rows and m columns with expression equals to n square plus m square end. So initially it will take value of n is equals to 1, then it will take initially m is equals to 5. We'll execute this equation and assign the value to a matrix. Next, with n is equals to same value 1, now m will change to from 5 to 4, and it will execute this below expression n square plus m square. Again, in this way, the m will take values from 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Each time it will execute the new value of m with original value of n as 1. Once m reaches from 5 to 1, now n will change to 2, from 1 to 2. And similarly, the n will go on changing from 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, changing of n from 1 to 2 or 2 to 3 and 3 to 4, 4 to 5. In between them, m will be executed 5 times. That will take value from 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. So the result of this is we got a matrix of n by m. So it is a 5 by 5 matrix with these values. So these value we got as A into bracket n comma m is equal to n square plus m square. Next program, x input, enter any value, display, if it's greater than 0, display 0, less than 0, negative. So it means enter the value, if it is 0, it will be negative, greater than 0, positive, less than 0, negative. Plotting graph using MATLAB. X is equal to 1 colon 10, y equals to x, plot xy. Means x and y will take the same values with a title and x label and y label. So y2 is equal to x square. Plot xy2. The result is this. On x label will give the name to the x coordinate, y label will give the y coordinate with the title. This is the program for the sinusoidal waveform. Generation of sinusoidal waveform. See, the first line is a comment line with a 2% signs. Will these lines are not executed. Okay, so let us start with this first statement. T is equals to 1 ranging from minus 1 to 1 with a difference of 1/100. F is equals to 1. X is equal to sine 2 pi f2. Plot t comma x, label time, y label, amplitude, title, sinusoidal wave. So this is the program for the generation of sinusoidal waveform with a standard equation x is equal to sine 2 pi ft. F is the frequency, that is 1. T, that will each time it will change values from minus 1 to 1 with a difference of 1/100. This will result in a plotting of a sine wave. Cosine wave. In similar manner, it is possible to plot a cosine wave. So taking a value of t is equal to minus 1 to 1, 1/100, f is equals to 1, standard equation x is equal to cos 2 pi ft. Plot t x, x label, y label and title. So this is the cosine wave with title as cosine wave. X label will give the name to the x ordinate, then time, and y label will give the name to the y coordinate as amplitude. Question: the continuous statement exists the current iteration in nested loop. Is it true or false? The answer is true. These are the references. Thank you.